area and its boundary. Class 5, subject maths. Prepared by Mrs. Seema Chakraborty, PRT KV number 1, Ishapur. Objectives of the lesson plan: a child can estimate and measure, understands the concept of area in terms of square units, understands the concept of perimeter, concludes the fact that if the area of two figures are same, it's not necessary that their perimeter must be same. Gains the competencies like ability in computation and develops problem solving ability. Can use the learning in real life situation. Understands the way to find the area and perimeter of regular and irregular shapes. Now, what are the content matter? Guess or estimate the area by seeing the size of the object, placing the squares and to find the area. What's the concept of the perimeter? Bigger and the smaller units like square meter, square kilometer. Usage of graph papers to denote area. Now, let me begin this chapter with a story. One day, Tom and Tigger went to a cake shop and bought the cakes. They have different sizes of cakes, and so they were confused whose cake was bigger. So they started quarreling. Tom said, "My cake is bigger." Tigger said, "No, my cake is bigger." Now look at children, these two cakes. One of the cake is having the length of 6 cm, another breadth is having 5 cm. Another cake is having the length of 11 cm and the breadth of 3 cm. Now let you find out whose cake is bigger. Both of them were really confused. Then their friend Minnie came and she suggested to make the squares of 1 cm side and place on the two cakes. The cake which would contain more square, it was the bigger than other one. Both of them agreed. Then Minnie started putting the squares. Now Tigger's cake, 6 in Tom's cake is here, 6 into 5, there are 30 squares. And in Tigger's cake, there are 11 into 3, that is 33 squares. So obviously, Tigger's cake is bigger than Tom's cake. So, I think everybody could understand. You have already read the chapter, how many squares. Just by counting the number of squares, you can also find out the area of two-dimensional object. Here the cakes are two-dimensional. If you take the two dimensions here, length and breadth, and putting the squares on it, you would find out whose cake is bigger. Now another activity for you, this is covering with stamps. You have to put the stamps lengthwise as well as breadthwise. Each stamp is having 4 square centimeter area. So now you find out the area of this total rectangle after covering with the stamps. Now here are certain questions for you. How many stamps can be placed to cover the rectangle? Is it less than 30 or more? What is the area of the rectangle if 24 stamps of each 4 square centimeter covers the rectangle? Is it more or less than 100 square centimeter? So here is the solution for you. But children, I must suggest you first to find out yourself. Then you see the solution what is given here. Now certain practice time questions. Here, Minnie thought of tiling her kitchen floor with red squares, tiles. Each side of the tile is 10 cm. Her kitchen is 220 cm in length and 180 cm wide. How many tiles will she need? Length of her kitchen is equal to 220 cm. That means 22 square tiles can be placed in its length of side 10 cm. breadth of her kitchen is equal to 180 centimeter. That means 18 square tiles can be placed in its breadth of side 10 centimeter. So the total number of tiles required are 22 into 18 is equal to 396 tiles. Now another activity for you, sharing of land. Ramu is a farmer. He wants to divide his land equally among his three sons, Ram, Shyam and Yadu, so that each piece of land has one tree. Now his land looks like this after division, after dividing this land into three parts, and each part is having one tree. Now find out the area and perimeter of each land. Who will need the longest wire for fencing? Longest wire for fencing means you have to find out the perimeter. So Ram needs 26 meter of rope to fence his land. Shyam needs 27 meter of rope to fence his land. Yadu needs 25 meter of rope to fence his land. Now find out how does it happen. Now another activity for you, draw a square of 9 square centimeter, write A on it, draw another square with double the side, write B on it, and then find out the area and the perimeter of each square. And find out the conclusion. These are the hypotheses. You have to find out the conclusion behind it. Now it's a wonderful two ponds, and these are all irregular ponds. Now here there are two ponds in a village. The fish in the ponds are dying because of the pollution. Please try to save the ponds. Now here 1 centimeter on this ground drawing is equal to 1 kilometer on the ground that you have already read in mapping your way chapter. So how many centimeter are the length of the boundary of the pond A and pond B in the drawing? So use thread for the measurement and find out the perimeter, and then you think of it, how would you keep safe these ponds from pollution. Think of certain strategies. So children, what did you learn from this chapter? The first thing you learned, guessing of area of any rectangular figure, and of course to find out it, identifying the measurement in square centimeter, square meter and square kilometer, and then you have to understand how to find out the area and perimeter of regular and irregular figures. Thank you children, explore yourself, find out, think critically and constructively and come to the conclusion. That's all in this chapter. So certain evaluation part is there. Can you guess the area of a rectangle of 1 centimeter wide and 80,000 meter long? Imagine how long that boundary will be. Sanya made a greeting card of 11 centimeter long and whose perimeter is 44 centimeter. What will be its breadth? Arushi made a square handkerchief of area 100 square centimeter. What is the length of each side? A thin wire 20 centimeter long is formed into a rectangle. If the width of this rectangle is 4 centimeter, what is its length? So here is certain bibliography I prepared. I refer the textbook of class 5 of National Council of Educational Research and Training and the split up of syllabus printed and issued by Kendriya Vidyalaya Sangathan, Kolkata region. Acknowledgement, I thank chairperson here, Rampal, Professor, Department of Education, Delhi University, Delhi, of our contribution towards this textbook. I convey my special thanks to Director in CRT and thanks to these following websites. So thank you children. And at last I have learned how to find the area and perimeter of different regular and irregular figures. So Raj is asking, will you? Thank you children, explore, bye bye.